And just add something, but Americans ask, many Americans ask now, and I think fairly, why now? We've known about Iraq for a long time, why now? There are several answers to the question. You've heard a couple of them already. There is one more, and we need to be honest about it. It is post-9/11. It is different. You've heard people say 9/11 changed everything. I don't think it changed everything, but it did change some things. And one thing it changed was our view of the world and our view of our own security and our view, if you will, the trigger, the threshold for action. The unthinkable became thinkable on 9/11. There will be debated, I suppose, to the end of time, and we'll have endless congressional hearings on how much notice we were on about 9/11 and whether more should have been done. I would submit whatever the evidence we had on which we should have acted, or maybe should not have acted, obviously we should have acted, on 9/11, there is more evidence that we should act in regard to Iraq. We're certainly on evidence about Saddam Hussein and what he's up to, what his intentions are, and what he has. It would be, I think, unconscionable for a leader, having been in the position of leadership in the country at the time of 9/11, to look at the facts and circumstances in Iraq and conclude that nothing should be done, we should just wait. That's an impossible moral conclusion, it seems to me.
Thank you.